Today I made this puppy chow inside of my car by leaving chocolate and peanut butter to sit in the sun. When I came back to my car, I found them both perfectly melted, so I added it to the cereal and then mixed it together and put it into my freezer. Once it finished freezing, I took it back out to my car so I could add the best part, the powdered sugar. It tasted amazing, but it was really sad because my parents left yesterday, so they weren't here to eat it and I had to eat it alone. My goal was to put Starbucks out of business by making cake pops inside of my car. The only issue was I think I left my car to sit in the sun a little bit too long because the cake had popped perfectly, but when it came to the frosting, it was very burnt. I was not going to give up though, so I went to the store and bought some icing and then poured my sprinkles on top of them. I then put it next to a Starbucks cake pop and you honestly couldn't even tell a difference, right? Today I'm gonna see what happens when I leave 4 pints of ice cream to sit inside of my hot car. To make this happen, I took 2 pints of rainbow ice cream, cut them open, and I'm going to leave them to sit in the sun. In the comments, let me know how long you think it's gonna take for these to melt and come back tonight to see if you were right. I managed to make my own chocolate bar today by leaving a bunch of different candies to melt in the sun. When I came back to my car, the candy was a little bit too chunky to be a chocolate bar, so I smushed it down, put it into my freezer, and then I had one massive bar. Once I took a bite, I was actually in shock at how delicious this was. This is the best thing I've ever had in my entire life. If Bill Nye and Willy Wonka had a baby, I'm pretty sure it would be me. Because today I found out what happens if you leave a giant gummy bear to melt inside of your hot car.
Oh my God. Rest in peace, little guy.
I hope you had the time of your life. I feel kind of bad for murdering this guy, but at least he tasted good and his legacy will live on forever. I made ice cream soup today by leaving 4 pints of cut open ice cream to sit inside of my hot car. I asked you guys to guess how long it would take for the ice cream to go from this to this, and the answer was 32 minutes. It basically just turned into an ice cream ocean, but I still dove in anyways.
The gummy bears all melted.
It's 90 degrees today in Los Angeles, so I'm gonna see if it's hot enough to make eggs and bacon inside of my car. To start, I laid the bacon down on a baking sheet pan. Then I cracked the eggs and got yolk everywhere. Now I'm going to leave my car to sit in the sun all day long, but come back tonight to see if it was hot enough to make me breakfast for dinner. Earlier today, I left uncooked eggs and bacon to sit inside of my hot car. I was hoping when I came back that they would be cooked. However, I think I dreamt a little bit too big because my breakfast for dinner looked absolutely disgusting. I'm sitting in my car doing the voiceover for this, and I decided I want to do something new tomorrow. So, instead of commenting what I should make in my car tomorrow, I want you to comment what I should eat. What I should have for coffee, what I should have for breakfast, what I should have for lunch, what I should have for dinner, what I should have for snacks. You guys are going to control everything that I eat tomorrow. I hope that that makes sense. Bye. Good morning, TikTok. Today I'm letting your comments decide everything that I eat. First up is a nice coffee from Dunkin' Donuts with almond milk and pumpkin swirl. Now, I've only tried Dunkin' Donuts coffee one time and I absolutely hated it, but I do like pumpkin, so I'm hoping that this can save the day. It's not that it's bad. It just tastes so artificial. It weirdly gives me hints of like nail polish remover. Ugh. Eat only food that is green for breakfast and lunch. Okay. To find my green food, I decided to go to this healthy grocery store called Erewhon. I quickly realized that even a lot of the green items also had other colors inside of them. To make sure I didn't cheat on this challenge, I ended up with broccolini, a customized green wrap, and a green juice. I mean, it looked very pretty, but I'm not gonna lie, it really needed some sort of sauce. I just kind of felt like I was a turtle. But honestly, my body probably needed this after all the food I eat that's baked inside of my car.
Eat only foods that are pink for breakfast and lunch. I can try.
To kick off this challenge, I decided to get a pitaya bowl with no toppings for breakfast. I then very quickly realized that I was going to basically just be eating sugar for the rest of the day because there's not many foods that are actually pink. So when it came to my lunch, I ended up with a cake pop, a cupcake, a pink drink, macaroons, and a bunch of pink candy. Sure, I don't think a human should probably have that much sugar in one meal, but you know what? I'm here for a good time, not a long time. Only eat foods that start with the letter M. I could try. To kick off my M food tour, I got the most insane maple donut and an iced mocha. For lunch, I decided to get one of my favorite mac and cheeses. It's actually gluten-free and you would never know. Staying on my M grind, my snacks were mango, matcha, and a muffin. For dinner, I found a place called House of Meatballs, so I went there and got some meatballs and they were pretty good. And to end my day, I got a McFlurry from McDonald's. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for naming me Matt and not Zebra.
Only eat foods that are the color black for both breakfast and lunch. This should be a fun day of eating.
To kick off this challenge, I started my morning with chocolate waffles and a black coffee. After breakfast, I went and got a charcoal latte. And then for lunch, I really branched out of my comfort zone by finding this black chicken. I really had no idea what I was eating, but it had a black ranch sauce, and I think that I liked it. Finally, to finish up the food tour, I got a charcoal ice cream with Oreos. Now, can we please say a moment of silence for my stomach?
Get ice cream for dinner? Pull my leg.
One of my favorite places to go get ice cream is from this place, Kith. It's located inside of a parking garage, and it is very aesthetically pleasing, and I always feel really uncool when I'm inside of this place. However, I still continue to go because the ice cream is incredible. I get a non-dairy milkshake with cookie dough and Oreos. I also decided to buy one of their really overpriced t-shirts because the box was really cool, and now hopefully I'll fit in more when I go.
Only eat rainbow-colored foods for both breakfast and lunch? This will be a colorful day of eating.
To kick off this challenge, I had a rainbow latte and a rainbow donut for breakfast. For lunch, I had one of the most insane things I've ever seen in my entire life, a rainbow pizza. It was so wild looking, but so delicious. Now for dessert, I thought I was just gonna have a cake pop, but then I ended up finding myself at the place that serves the infamous explosion cake. These cakes are definitely meant for a massive birthday party, but I just sat outside and ate it myself.
Eat only yellow foods for both breakfast and lunch? This will be fun.
To kick off my day of yellow eating, I had eggs, lemonade, and french fries for breakfast. I then went to a place called Sugar Factory where I got emoji and banana candies and a giant duck lemonade. To balance out the sweets, I decided to get cheese fries and a quesadilla. This lunch was a perfect balance of both sweet and salty, and most importantly, it was all yellow.
Ask Siri what I should eat for breakfast and lunch? Okay.
Hey Siri, where should I go get breakfast?
One possibility is 26 Beach Restaurant. Is that the one you're looking for?
I guess.
I let Siri take the wheel and she took me to this restaurant that I hadn't ever heard of before, but the vibes were incredible. I literally just picked the first thing on the menu and next thing I knew was I had a massive French toast breakfast sandwich sitting in front of me. I've never wanted to hug Siri more.
That is amazing.
However, once I got to the end, I realized that I may have taken a little bit overboard because I had never felt so sick.
Only eat foods that are blue for both breakfast and lunch? Challenge accepted.
To kick off my day of blue eating, I started my morning with a blue latte and a blue acai bowl at the beach for breakfast. My lunch was definitely the highlight of my day when I found these blue sliders at the happiest place on earth, Sugar Factory. To satisfy my sweet tooth, I got a blue velvet cake and a vegan blue milkshake for dessert. Roses are red, violets are blue, and after today, I am too.
Only eat food that is red for both breakfast and lunch. This should be fun.
To kick off this challenge, I had these insane red velvet pancakes and a beet strawberry smoothie for breakfast. I then went and found this incredible ice cream sandwich that was watermelon sorbet stuffed inside of a watermelon. To finish off the challenge, I ended my day with tacos that were served in red tortillas for lunch. Now my stomach is red, E for a break.
Eat only foods that you don't like. I don't know why I'm gonna do this, but let's go.
To make this awful challenge happen, I went around the town and got all of the foods that I hate. Dunkin' Donuts coffee, pineapple and mushroom pizza, applesauce, fruit, and pickles. This was by far one of the most traumatizing meals of my entire life.
Only eat food that starts with the letter B. Okay, bro.
To kick off my day of bee eating, I had this colorful bagel for breakfast. I then drove from LA to San Diego to go to a coffee shop called Better Buzz. After the buzz, I got a blue drink from Sonic, a bacon sandwich from a place called Borden Brew, and made my way over to Dairy Queen for a blizzard. But then something tragic happened.
Only food that starts with the letter C. Well, let's see if I can do this.
To make this challenge happen, I started my morning with a coffee, a charcoal lemonade, and a cosmic chia pudding for breakfast. For lunch, I went with a cheeseburger, carne asada tacos, and a coconut smoothie. For dessert, I was going to just get chocolate, and then I found a chocolate-covered Twinkie. I need some alone time with this Twinkie, but I'll see you tomorrow.
Only food that starts with the letter K. Okay.
To prove that I could easily complete this challenge, I started my morning with a breakfast item called a kachapuri. I'm not sure if that's how it's actually pronounced, but it tasted delicious. After breakfast, I had a flight of kombucha, a kiwi popsicle, and a key lime pie. For lunch, I had kebabs and a Kit Kat. To end the day, I went and got a bag of kettle corn and a kale salad. I don't really love the taste of kale, so I decided to add the kettle corn on top of it, and then it tasted A-OK.
Only eat foods that are the color purple today. Well, challenge accepted.
Today's challenge kind of started on a rough note when I got a purple latte and then I tripped and dropped it. In hopes of picking myself back up, I went and got an acai bowl. I then sort of fell back down again because I spent 3 hours driving around LA looking for purple foods and all I could find were two ube ice creams. To make up for the lost time, I decided to go to a soda shop and get a bunch of purple candy and a grape soda. This meal definitely revived me, but probably took a few years off my life.
Spend the day only eating foods that are the color white. This may be a weird day of eating.
To kick off this challenge, I started my morning at Starbucks where I got a vanilla bean frappuccino, egg white bites, and a bagel with cream cheese. I then grabbed a vanilla yogurt from the farmer's market and mashed potatoes from KFC. For lunch, I went to a sushi restaurant and just asked the waitress to bring me any fish that was the color white. For dessert, I got a birthday cake Kit Kat, a vanilla cupcake, and coconut gelato with meringue bites on top. My poor stomach is so confused.
Only eat vegan food for a whole day? Challenge accepted.
To kick off this challenge, I started my morning with vegan chicken and waffles from this bougie restaurant in LA. I then grabbed a vegan carne asada taco. For lunch, I had my life change when I got a burger and a milkshake from this place that is basically the vegan version of In-N-Out Burger. I never would have known this was vegan. For dinner, I decided to go to a vegan pasta place and I got the carbonara. Well, that was my day of eating and I guess I'm a vegan now.
Only eat foods that are under a dollar? On behalf of me and my wallet, challenge accepted.
Now, I thought this challenge was going to be easy until this happened.
Do you have anything that is under a dollar?
No. No, you're not, sorry.
I was beginning to get very hangry, but then luckily I found two items from Taco Bell, and then I hit my jackpot when I found my first dollar menu at Del Taco. I'm not gonna lie to you, this was not good at all, but it did the trick. For dinner, the luck continued when I found another dollar menu at Burger King. This challenge definitely helped my wallet, but for sure hurt my insides.
Only eat foods that are the color brown. Challenge accepted.
To kick off this challenge, I had bacon and pancakes for breakfast. These pancakes were spiritual. The butter melted into syrup. I then went and got a smoothie, nuts, and a cookie, and a frozen coffee inside of this little waffle cup. For lunch, I got brown rice, pinto beans, and chicken. And for part one of my dessert, I got cornflake ice cream and milk bar pie. Then for dessert part two, I got a Belgian waffle that was dipped in milk chocolate. Well, after everything I ate today, I'm pretty sure that my toilet will be eating brown tonight too.
Only eat pumpkin flavored things. I've been waiting for this one. Turn it up!
To kick off my day of pumpkin eating, I got a pumpkin cold brew, pumpkin spice latte, and a pumpkin muffin from Starbucks. I then made my way to Jamba Juice for a pumpkin smash smoothie. I let the real games begin when I went to the home of all things pumpkin, Trader Joe's, where I basically bought one of everything, including pumpkin bars, brownies, bagels, cream cheese, chips, pasta, oatmeal, cereal, pancakes, crackers, cookies, and soup. Now my kitchen is like the definition of squash goals.
Because Walmart bought TikTok yesterday and saved the love of my life, today I'm going to be eating my breakfast and lunch from Walmart.
To kick off this challenge, I bought a whole new outfit, and then for breakfast, I made my way to the cereal aisle, which is the best part of Walmart because they have the most insane flavors. I ended up going with the Dunkin' Donuts cereal and a Funfetti cereal. For lunch, they had a full takeout restaurant in the back, so I got a chicken teriyaki bowl. Walmart, I love you so much, I think I'm going to legally change my name to Walmart.
According to this comment, I need to get healthy. So today I'm gonna only eat vegetables for both breakfast and lunch.
To find my healthy food, I went to this vegan restaurant called IHOP and got their broccoli pancakes. For lunch, I went to this salad place called Chick-fil-A and got their kale salad and a side of cauliflower. Then for my afternoon dessert, I went to this place called Salt and Straw and got an apple. I now feel like a new person after this healthy day of eating.
Today I'm gonna spend the day only eating different variations of potato. Wish me luck.
To make this challenge happen, I started my morning with potato pancakes and hash browns. For lunch, I had Japanese sweet potatoes, potato chips, and delicious potato tacos. I then decided to treat myself to a nice dinner where I indulged in truffle fries and sweet potato gnocchi. Check back tomorrow to see if I look like this.
Only eat food from the Dollar Tree. Okay.
So this was actually my first Dollar Tree experience, and I had no idea that everything was actually only a dollar, and I also could not believe how many incredible things that they had. For breakfast, I got Frosted Flakes and Kool-Aid. For lunch, I got nachos and cheese dip. The cheese was a little bit concerning, but we're not going to talk about it. For dinner, I got ramen noodles. And for the grand finale, I found the most insane items for the dessert, including a freaking Krabby Patty. Honestly, call the cops, because this day of eating was a steal.
Only eat clear-colored foods for the entire day. I have no idea how I'm gonna do this, but challenge accepted.
Now, at first I thought I was gonna be stuck drinking water all day long, but then I realized I just needed to get creative. So for my first meal of the day, I had clear spring rolls and a coconut water. I then went and got a soup with coconut broth and these clear glass noodles. Now, the thing I was most proud of was my dessert creation when I went and got coconut shaved ice and clear rock candy. I can't believe I didn't think I was gonna be able to do this. I obviously wasn't thinking clearly.
Only eat foods that start with the letter L for an entire day. Okay, let's do it.
To make this challenge happen, I started my morning with a latte and a box of Lucky Charms. For lunch, I had a regular lemonade, a watermelon lemonade, and a bowl of lentil soup. For dinner, I got super fancy and got a lobster roll. I actually had never had lobster before, but I was very into this. To finish off the day, I went and got a lemon olive oil cake for dessert. And just like that, challenge completed. I'm glad I didn't take an L on this one.
Only eat dessert for 24 hours? I think this may be the best day of my entire life.
To kick off my day of dessert eating, I started my morning with a cookie dough donut. For lunch, I went with a brownie sundae inside of a churro waffle cone. For dinner, I went and got a sandcastle sundae, which is 5 scoops of ice cream, cookies, whipped cream, gummy bears, and sunglasses all inside of a sand bucket. To complete this challenge, it was time to order one of my favorite desserts of all time, edible arrangements. From the cookies to the pumpkin cheesecake, this was the most perfect ending to a delicious day.
Spend the day only eating your favorite childhood snacks. Challenge accepted.
To kick off this challenge, I started my morning with Dunkaroos and a Pop-Tart. I then made my way to the grocery store and started spending my life savings on every single childhood snack I could think of. I was able to justify my spending though because I was using the app Shopkick while I was shopping and I was making money back as I would scan items. Once I was done shopping, I took all my snacks to the nearest park and I lived my best childhood life.
I just got a Starbucks gift card for buying this seltzer. I'm gonna be drunk. To celebrate being verified, today I'm gonna only eat foods that are the color teal. Wish me luck.
To make this challenge happen, I started my morning with a blue raspberry icy. I then had my life completely changed when I found this colorful grilled cheese for lunch. For dinner, I had teal pasta noodles with teal fettuccine Alfredo sauce. For dessert, my friend got me this amazing little TikTok cake, so I decided to throw myself a little party. In all seriousness, thank you so much for watching these videos. I have so much fun making them, and I really hope I can make you smile.
Only eat hot Cheeto foods for a day. I don't even like hot Cheetos, but challenge accepted.
To kick off this challenge, I started my morning with the most insane box of donuts that were not only topped with flaming hot Cheetos, but also bacon and sriracha. As if that wasn't insane enough, I then went and found myself a hot Cheetos pizza for lunch that had ranch drizzled on top of the hot Cheetos. For dinner, I continued to ruin my stomach by getting a flaming hot Cheetos fried chicken sandwich that had mac and cheese balls inside of it. Then to wrap up the day, I got a hot Cheetos ice cream for dessert. After today, I'm not sure who's gonna dislike hot Cheetos more, me, my stomach, or my toilet.
Only eat neon colored foods for an entire day. Challenge accepted.
To make this challenge happen, I started my morning with neon egg whites and a snow cone. For lunch, I had a bowl with neon rice and red shrimp. Dinner was definitely my main event when I got to try this hot chicken sandwich that is served on a pink bun. It was a perfect balance of spicy and sweet, just like me. To finish off this challenge, it was time for dessert where I got this incredible rainbow cake and neon gelato. I really hope my future is as bright as my stomach after today.
Only eat foods that are the color gold for the entire day. Challenge accepted.
To begin my day of gold eating, I had a gold Belgian waffle for breakfast. The craziness then continued when I found this sparkly gold pizza for lunch. For dinner, I went full Kardashian by ordering myself a gold cocktail, gold sushi, and gold cookies. To finish off the day, I had a 24-karat gold chimney cone for dessert. I know I typically treat my stomach like a trash can, but I think today it struck gold.
Only eat foods that start with the letter Q. I think this is gonna be quite the challenge.
So at first I thought I was gonna be stuck eating Quaker oats and Q-tips, but then I quickly realized that there was way more to this quest. For breakfast, I had a quiche and quinoa. For lunch, I went to one of my favorite spots and got queso and a quesadilla. Then for dinner, I decided to really quiz the strength of my stomach by ordering a quarter pounder. I'm not gonna lie, it made me extremely queasy, but hey, it was an A to my Q.
Only eat cookie dough flavored things for the entire day. I think this is gonna be a very sweet day of eating.
To make this challenge happen, I started my morning with cookie dough pancakes and a cookie dough donut. For lunch, I got 3 pints of edible cookie dough and cookie dough popcorn. For dinner, I went on the healthier side with a cookie dough salad. I then got a cookie dough ice cream sandwich and finished my day with an edible cookie dough sundae. I may have gotten some cavities today, but I dough it all for you.
Only eat sandwiches for an entire day. You guys are seriously going to ruin my stomach, but challenge accepted.
To begin my day of carb eating, I had a croissant breakfast sandwich. I then made my way over to my favorite sandwich spot in all of LA, Carla Cafe. This place is kind of a secret, but since we're friends, I decided to let you in on it. By the time dinner came around, the last thing I wanted to do was eat a sandwich, but I turned on my yeast mode and ate it anyways. Even though my stomach was going awry, I finished my day with an ice cream sandwich for dessert. I know I was on a roll today, but I think I'm ready to go gluten-free.
Only eat mini foods for both breakfast and lunch? I think this may be a little bit difficult, but challenge accepted.
To begin this small but mighty challenge, I had mini pancakes, a mini coffee, and mini crepes for breakfast. For lunch, I had customized little mini pizzas, along with 3 mini hot dogs and a mini hamburger. I was still kind of hungry, but luckily it was time for dessert, where I had a mini pumpkin and apple pie and mini cupcakes. Today was a good day, but you know what they say, it's the little things.
Only eat foods that are the color gray? I guess today is the day. Challenge accepted.
To begin my day of gray eating, I had an Earl Grey boba and 4 gray donuts for breakfast. Lunch was a lot less exciting when I had sardines for the first and probably last time. For dinner, I went and got oysters. I know a lot of people enjoy them, but I personally have the palate of a 12-year-old, so they're just not for me. To finish off the day, I had gray ice cream, which made me happy when my stomach was gray.
Only eat Halloween-themed foods for the entire day. I think this may spook my stomach, but challenge accepted.
To make this challenge happen, I said boo-hoo with these spooky donuts for breakfast. For lunch, it was the opposite of a basic witch with this black bun burger. It was love at first bite. I then had a zombie brain boba and made my way to Salt and Straw for some ice cream. These flavors were insane. One even had chocolate-covered crickets inside of it. To finish off the day, I said trick-or-treat with the cutest little Halloween macaroons. What did the mummy say when Halloween was over? That's a wrap.
Only eat avocados for an entire day. This may guac my world, but challenge accepted.
At first, I thought I was going to be stuck eating normal avocados all day long, but not in 2020. For breakfast, I had 3 pieces of avocado toast and an avocado smoothie. For lunch, I had 2 stuffed avocados and avocado french fries. For my snacks, I had both guacamole and avocado hummus. Then to finish off the day, I had the most epic slice of an avocado salad pizza for dinner and an avocado boba for dessert. And now I think my stomach has officially hit guac bottom.
Only eat spicy foods for an entire day. I think I may need these, but challenge accepted.
To start my day of spicy eating, I had Inferno chicken and waffles and LA's spiciest breakfast burrito. I then said a prayer as I ate these spicy noodles and I nearly died. As if that wasn't enough, I then went and had a delicious but spicy poke bowl. And then I decided to really make myself miserable by going and getting a fried chicken sandwich that you have to sign a waiver to eat because it's that hot. It barely even touched my mouth, and yet it was the most painful thing I've ever experienced. I attempted to wash the pain away with 2 spicy margaritas and 2 spicy carrot cupcakes, but I honestly could not feel my lips, so I went home and I gave myself a milk shower.
Only eat sushi for the entire day? I can roll with that.
To start my day of sushi eating, I had a sushi donut and a platter of sushi fruit. For lunch, I had a rainbow roll, and for dinner, I had the most epic box of sushi that included a hot Cheetos roll. For dessert, I had the cutest box of candy sushi that made me so happy. Today really was a rice day.
Only eat cheesy foods for an entire day? This should be Gouda. Challenge accepted.
To begin my day of cheese eating, I had a cheese waffle and 2 cheese stuffed biscuits for breakfast. For lunch, I couldn't help but saying cheese when I bit into this mac and cheese stuffed egg roll. Just when I thought I couldn't get fatter than that, I had the most insane cheese fries, plain mac and cheese, and 6 cheese pasta for dinner. To finish the day, I had 3 slices of cheesecake, and now my stomach is screaming, Jesus Christ.
Only eat pizza for the entire day? Challenge accepted.
To make this challenge happen, I had an egg, bacon, sausage, and hash brown breakfast pizza on a sweet potato crust. For lunch, I was the king of health when I got a salad pizza. I then got a pineapple pizza, and if this is your favorite type of pizza, I just don't trust you.
For dinner, I turned into a real man with this meat pizza.
And then I quickly turned back to myself when I found this Nutella pizza for dessert. Wow, today was a slice day. This challenge really stole a piece of my heart.
Only eat strawberry-flavored foods for a whole day? I think this is gonna be a very interesting day of eating, but challenge accepted.
To begin this berry sweet challenge, I had strawberry French toast and 2 epic strawberry donuts. I then had a strawberry lemonade and croissant and made my way to find a strawberry milk that I had to shake up like a Polaroid picture. For the main event, I had a berry disgusting strawberry pasta that I luckily washed away with a delicious strawberry ice cream and cupcake. My stomach is currently berry confused.
Only eat birthday cake flavored foods for a whole day? Well, it is my mom's 61st birthday, so Challenge accepted.
To begin the day, I shocked my mom with the most insane stack of birthday cake waffles. For lunch, I treated her to birthday cake butter and cookie dough, along with the world's best birthday cake bread pudding. We then indulged in the most delicious vegan birthday cake cinnamon rolls and cookies, along with a scoop of birthday cake ice cream. To finish off the day, my mom was doing a happy dance as we bit into one of the iconic birthday cakes from Milk Bar. Happy birthday, Mom. You really are my best friend, and I love you so much. Thanks for giving birth to me and my crazy stomach.
Only eat cereal for a whole day? I think this is gonna be seriously amazing. Challenge accepted.
To begin this challenge, I had a Cinnamon Toast Crunch latte and a box of cereal donuts. I then went to my favorite dessert bar and got 3 cups of the TikTok famous pancake cereal. To follow up the pancakes, I had cornflake French toast along with a Cinnamon Toast Crunch cookie and Muddy Buddies. I then found a food truck that just served cereal, so I got a milkshake along with a bowl of Funfetti cereal. To finish off the challenge, I just want to say thank you so much for 3 million followers. That is insane. I hope I'm a better TikToker than I am an artist.
Only eat Mexican food for an entire day. Challenge accepted.
Now, this has been one of my most requested challenges, so I knew I really needed to send it today. To begin, I had huevos rancheros in a breakfast burrito. I then had tacos, chips, and salsa in a chicken tortilla soup. For dinner, I had these loaded chicken nachos in a burrito that was literally the size of a newborn baby. To finish up this challenge, I had churros along with Mexican wedding cookies that I dipped in Mexican hot chocolate for dessert. And now, if anybody needs me, I'm gonna be in the bathroom.
Only eat peanut butter for an entire day? Now that's a little nutty if you ask me, but challenge accepted.
Now if you thought I was just gonna eat normal peanut butter all day long, how dare you underestimate me like that. For breakfast, I found the most delicious peanut butter and jelly donuts along with a peanut butter crepe. For lunch, I went to one of my favorite places and got frozen peanut butter Greek yogurt along with a marshmallow peanut butter jelly sandwich. I then completely had my life changed when I found a peanut butter and jelly hamburger that I served with a side of ice cream for dipping sauce. For dessert, I had a peanut butter cupcake and a peanut butter brownie, and now I'm pretty sure I'm never gonna eat peanut butter ever again.
Only eat heart-shaped foods for an entire day? Challenge accepted.
To begin this lovely challenge, I had a heart-shaped latte and heart-shaped Pop-Tarts for breakfast. For lunch, I had this beating egg sandwich. And for dinner, I had a piece of my heart stolen when I found this epic heart-shaped pizza. For dessert, I got these delicious sugar cookies, and as I was leaving, I saw a billboard for Miley Cyrus's new album, Plastic Heart. Which was ironic, because I think this album is the only reason my heart's still beating.
Only eat mac and cheese for an entire day? Challenge accepted.
To begin this cheesy challenge, I had a mac and cheese breakfast burger. For lunch, I had my mind blown when I found a hot Cheetos mac and cheese pizza along with a normal cup of mac and cheese. For dinner, I entered mac and cheese heaven with a bowl of truffle mac and cheese and a mac and cheese bacon sandwich. For dessert, I decided to really put my stomach through it with an 8-cheese mac and cheese casserole. Now I think I'm gonna legally change my name from Matt to Mac.
Today I turned 24, so in honor of my birthday, I'm gonna spend the day only eating edible versions of my face. If you're confused what that means, keep watching.
To begin my day of selfie eating, I had a pancake that was in the shape of my face from Dan Cake. I was surprised how good I tasted, so I decided to keep the ball rolling with these funny face cookies. As if that wasn't outrageous enough, I then had my face on a latte and a painted portrait on a cookie. To end the day, I decided to throw us a birthday party as a thank you for watching my content over the last 10 months. I am forever grateful. Cheers to another year.
Only eat hot dogs for an entire day? You can call me a wiener, because challenge accepted.
To begin this day of dog eating, I had a vegan hot dog with vegan mayonnaise. I then said a prayer for my stomach as I indulged in this chili cheese dog, a Snoop Dogg, and even a freaking hot Cheetos hot dog. I then made my way to the famous LA hotspot Pink's, where they gave me the JoJo Siwa treatment, and it honestly made my entire year. So when it comes to the question of who let the dogs out, tonight it's definitely gonna be me.
Only eat frozen food for an entire day? Challenge accepted.
At first, I was a little scared to do this challenge, but then I decided to let it go with frozen Eggos and frozen mac and cheese. I then froze my insides by ordering 13 scoops of ice cream inside of this flower pot. After that, I needed to get cold and healthy, so I said burr with a head of iceberg lettuce. To reward myself for that healthy choice, I then had a delicious froze egg. And just like that, the challenge is done. I don't know what I was so afraid of. I mean, the cold never bothered me anyway.
Only eat peppermint flavored foods for an entire day? Tis the season, so challenge accepted.
There was really only one way to start this challenge, and that was with a peppermint mocha and a peppermint mocha frappuccino. I then had my holiday dreams come true with this gingerbread waffle that was covered in peppermint bark. To maintain this sugar high, I had a box of peppermint pretzel snaps and a box of peppermint bark truffles. For dinner, I got very creative and made peppermint patty sandwiches with marshmallows. To end the day, I had a peppermint cupcake and a peppermint cookie, and now after all this sugar, my health is in mint condition.